Conducting the public hearing, just the standard things, and again, y'all have got a great staff that are assembling these things, getting them ready for you. You all are coming in, you all are basically working de facto for no pay, and you all have to come in and take time out of your busy schedules to conduct basically a civic duty on behalf of this county, and it is hard, and it is not appreciated enough, if you ask me. So first of all, I just want to say that out loud, because that's just the facts. But within the conduct of the actual, or of the public hearings, a couple things. First of all, treat both sides equally. Y'all know this is easy, but obviously you shouldn't give one side, both pro or con, more latitude than the other. So if you give one side an extra 10 minutes, then you give the other side. So, and then typically where you see this is in the real controversial adult entertainment facility. Not here, we have not had that in a long time, but you know, 500 people are again it, and there's one poor developer there, and he gets his or her 10 minutes, and then they need an hour and a half. Well, if you're going to give them the extra hour and a half, you got to give the other side plenty of time. So you all get that. The public hearing is just that. It is to hear from the public. There is no reason to get into a debate or discussion with a speaker. Now, I will say that if you have questions and you want to ask a question of anybody, that is your right. You do so at your peril. If you choose to engage and want to have a discussion, you do so not knowing what they're going to say in response to you, and obviously you could open up a huge can of worms. In addition, of course, to everybody in the audience just got the idea now that question and answer is okay, because you just talked to that person, they just asked you a question, you just answered. So does that mean that when I get up to ask a question, you're going to answer my question as well? Just be mindful about engaging in debate with a citizen. All that's legally required is to listen. Public hearing. Once you have engaged in a public hearing, you're fine. And the final thing, and this is, you know, to the chairman, just make sure to keep control of the meeting. I tell that to every chairman I deal with, but it's your meeting to control. The chairman is the presiding officer, and it's his or her obligation to try as best that they can to keep control of the meeting. And again, I'm not hearing this is a problem, but I'm giving this sort of generically, like this was any other body that I've ever given one of these speeches to. Any questions on that? Number three on just work sessions. I've covered a lot of this. The reality is that these work sessions, the only thing I wanted to emphasize was just at the work session, let's don't forecast our decision. A lot of times in the passion of the moment when you're debating, you may have already made your mind up, this is a bad deal, or vice versa, this is a good deal, this is a good zoning, this is a good whatever the action is, the action item for you is, keep it to yourself. Because you want the process to go through uncheckmarked with, you know, I knew at the work session this commissioner had made their mind up. You know how I knew that? Because here's where they're saying this is a bad idea. But you know what? The applicant hadn't even had the opportunity to come before you and give their side of it yet. Or you're in favor of it, and the opponents are saying, I never got a chance to come here and rail against it, which is what I want to do. Therefore, you didn't have the ability to listen to me before you made your mind up. And again, you've got to be careful of this, because what can happen sometimes is someone will get up and say, Madam Chairman, I would like to formally request that Planning Commissioner X recuse themselves because they had forecast their vote before they actually got to hear the public comment and actually have this hearing. And I know that on this date they said this, and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Now, there are ways to mitigate that, and to certainly not require that individual to recuse themselves, but it gets a little sticky. And the more emphatic they've been at the passionate town hall meeting when they said, I'll fight for your rights and never allow the new strip club to come into this jurisdiction, the harder it is to acknowledge or suggest they can be unbiased and neutral at the hearing when they have made those sorts of comments on the record. Everybody understand what I'm saying? Okay.